what was great about it, that era, was that you had Skyhooks, Sherbet, AC/DC, John Paul Young, and then people like William Shakespeare, Christy Allen, and you suddenly had a great bunch of artists, Australian artists, that were all so different. So we could have them on, you know, like 3 weeks later and then 3 weeks later again, you know?
Hello, I'm Johnny Farnham and this is Countdown. The first edition for 1975 in glorious colour. Throughout the year, we're going to bring you the most exciting people in Australia. Let's kick it off right now with one of Australia's fastest rising groups, Skyhooks.
One of my first big moments for Countdown was actually seeing the first show go to air in colour. I mean, that was a very exciting experience.
You watch a horror movie right there on my TV. Horror movie right there on my TV. Horror movie right there on my TV. Shocking me right out of my brain. It's shocking me right out of my brain. You watch a horror movie right there on my TV. Horror movie right there on my TV. Horror movie right there on my TV. Shocking me right out of my brain. It's shocking me right out of my brain.
They bounce with rock and roll, and it's Rose Tattoo with Big Bad Boy. Go Angry! Yeah.
whole generation of Australians grew up with Countdown, and through that whole period of time, I think music exploded. I think the strength of Countdown was phenomenal because it went to every country town, to every small place. So it really, on Sunday night, music took over the family home.
You're taking me there. I couldn't believe our love would last. It's coming on stronger, coming on so much faster. Get used to it, 'cause I'll be around.
Have a good AC/DC with Dirty Deeds Done Dirt Cheap.
AC/DC certainly was one where I've never known a studio audience or a studio to explode and have such energy as when AC/DC came out and performed.
So now let's look at the might of the New Zealand talent that has so much influence on the Australian charts. Welcome to the show, Richard Wilde, everybody. Yet another Kiwi about to break our charts.
You won't find nothing there. The streets know the address for the clothes you wear.
Skyhooks had a visual impact that Countdown was perfect for them. The fact that their songs were Australian and the lyrics were so Australian, and it really just caught on. And with Countdown's massive reach, it just enabled the whole Skylarks phenomena to happen a lot quicker than it would have happened.
Some people keep their egos in a bottom drawer. A fridge full of Leonard Cohen. Had to get drunk to walk out the door. And stay drunk to keep on going.
I love to have a beer with Molly because Meldrum's me mate. Hey, I love to have a beer with Duncan. Oh, I love to have a beer with Duncan. We drink in moderation and we never, ever, ever get rolling drunk.
It takes me back to Sunday school concerts. It's got a lovely amateurish feel about it, which I think is nice. I like it.
Every mother wants a boy like Elton. Every girl deserves the very best. Every mother wants a boy like Elton to press against her breast.
Bubble. Countdown was important to the industry, it was basically everything for the industry. Without Countdown, I don't think the industry would have gone up under the leaps and bounds that it did.
I hit the music!
But Libby was great that night. I mean, I couldn't stop kissing her, but it was a good night.
That was fun.
I can't stop kissing her.
Oh, no!
And that actually frightened me, because I thought I was seeing things. I thought, oh, God, I shouldn't have gone to that party last night or shouldn't have stayed out so late. I am now seeing sauce bottles, actually, sauce coming out of the bottle, you know?
And now we come to the most important part of the... Could I just have one glass of water, please?
Well, certainly the Prince Charles interview on Countdown was one of the most horrendous things I've ever gone through. One, because the intro I had to do before I introduced him had to be approved by Buckingham Palace and went backwards and forwards. It was very long, and I'm used to ad-lib, so I had to learn this thing. I learned it off by heart. I got to the studios and saw all the police there and the press corps, and I just went to pieces sort of thing.
I'm terribly sorry about this.
Yeah, it happens everywhere.
Doesn't?
Absolutely. But you don't have one of these teleprompters?
No, not
here. You don't?
Marvellous, and I want to say one thing. I don't think, in all of the episodes of Countdown I've seen, I don't think I've known you to be more fluent.
Shirley Storm with Every Little Bit.
Can't you see?
eclipse of the heart.
If you fall, I will catch you, I'll be waiting. Time after time. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you, I'll be
Now, it was always exciting at Countdown, you know, because you'd be there for anything up to four or six hours because you'd do a pre-tape or a run-through, and then the show. That was the other thing that was exciting, that it was live. You know, you'd and you sang live occasionally, and you also mimed, but the whole thing was, I never knew it to stop. I mean, once it was rolling, it was go.
I live my life and be free. I've got my eyes, I can see. I've got my mind and I'm free.
I've got my mind and I'm free.
I live my life and be free.
You have to face up. You can't run and hide.
should I come back on a hippie trailhead full of zombies? I met a strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under? A women go and men wonder.
The sad of you, terrible people. You know they're going out tonight to get the Bombay rocks off. But you, terrible people. Jack Kerouac condition and machine tank car. Studio 54 is the only place to dance for you. Triple B-ball. You know the garden's full of furniture, the house is full of plants.
Countdown was the pioneer of the video show, as we see now with MTV and VTV and all those different programs. Because in England there was Top of the Pops, but that was totally live and you had to re-record the numbers. And much the same in Europe. So Countdown was one of the first, if not the first, to have a concentration on video.
Mamma mia,
mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me, for me, for me.
Ça plane pour moi, ça plane pour moi, ça plane pour moi, 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 ça plane pour moi.
Yeah.
bucket. We know Major Tom's a junkie, strung out in heaven's mind, hitting that all-time low.
Countdown studio, our special guest direct from the UK, Tears for Fears, and Everybody Wants to Rule the World. Studio, it's a miracle. Welcome, Culture Club.
Oh,
You're one of the finest acts. You're one of the... Mickey. It's one of the finest acts to ever come out to this country. I think that you do, the four of you do yourselves, a lot of proud. I certainly think another countdown can happen, and I'll probably be killed for this, but I think it can only happen on the ABC. I don't think a music program can work a la like Countdown if it has commercial breaks in it. It needs to flow all the time. It needs to have that element of excitement and the element of musical numbers going from one to another. Yes, I think it's time that another Countdown started, or another show like Countdown started. The industry's crying out for it. And I'm sure the audience are crying out for it.